What's up, everybody?
Hi, we're here at Amoeba Hollywood. We're talking to Spinderella, and we're gonna see what's in your bag today.
I've been collecting 45s again, and I found this, the Nat, my Sharona, for 50 cents. Hip hop, of course, would not be what it is if it wasn't for these guys right here, Run DMC. This 45 actually has Mary Mary, which is one of my favorites.
Mary Mary, I need your hugging.
Another Run DMC piece, Run's House. Gotta have this. Okay, so another form of music that I love to play is the soulful R&B. This is Victim by Candy Staton. A table just for two. I kind of love that women, that movement back, you know, back in the 70s, and they were so, you know, strong-willed. Another old soulful classic. It's not really as old as that one, but this is mid-80s. This would be Ashford and Simpson, Solid, because I'm solid. Solid, you know that song. In that same realm of music, Cameo, gotta do it.
There's a special kind of person. Sometimes she's not all she seems. You only see what she wants you to see. And before you...
This is Dance With Me. This is a good song. This is like, you know, you could do a whole Rick James set and have a good time. The early 70s, the Flower Child, the era was really peace and beautiful. Like, the world is just beautiful, groovy. I mean, there's other words for it, but yeah, whatever you feel. But this one is a good one. This is Sly and the Family Stone, Hot Fun in the Summertime. Play this one. This is just, it's a lot of fun. And I was a kid, my dad used to play stuff like this, and that's exactly what we had. There was nothing wrong. I didn't know that Outkast had put this out. This is pretty recent, so they still are pressing 45s. This is Hey Ya. Every time I go into a record store, I look for the salt and pepper section to see what they have. Now, I have a lot of salt and pepper singles, 12 inches, but some things I don't have. I picked this up, Salt and Pepper. Get up. Everybody get up.
Get up.
This is a good time for Salt and Pepper too. We were having fun back then. So I picked up a couple I definitely wanted to represent. I usually get doubles when I, you know, if I'm gonna work with it or DJ with it or play with it, backspin it, juggle it, whatever. One of my favorite Salt and Pepper songs that I did not have would be My Mic Sounds Nice.
My mic sounds nice, check one. My mic sounds nice, check two.
I love this Salt and Pepper song. If you've heard it, then I know you probably enjoyed that one too. And my idol, Janet. How could we not do Janet? When I do that 80s pop set, it wouldn't be right if I didn't have like Control in there or Nasty Boys. But my favorite on this album is Pleasure Principle. That is absolutely my favorite of Janet Jackson's, period. Most of us young, middle-aged women loved Janet back in the 80s because she was so strong and she stood for a lot of great things. And she has some great music, so I had to get this. And the last thing I got is not really any music, but it has to do with one of my idols as a DJ. May he rest in peace. Two turntables and a microphone.
When did you first meet Jack?
Early 70s. I woke up one day and Jay was there, he never left.
We knew each other from like 7 years old, 8 years old.
We was in the same neighborhood, so everybody should just meet up on the avenue.
Jay was a partner, man. That was like a brother to me, man. We all grew up together.
Jay had two slices of bread. I had an egg or something. We got together, we made a sandwich, and we shared that sandwich.
Jam Master Jay is you know, most DJs globally idolized him because he kind of paved the way and opened the doors for DJs, period. And that is what's in Spinderella's bag.
Looking for the good stuff. Tighten up on your backstroke. Looking for the good stuff. Tighten up on your backstroke.